Hey everybody, David from Axe Annex here, and today I want to talk about this very whole game wash dipping formula. After a long hiatus in the hobby, I came back to it because of some posts I'd seen about this thing called Army Painter Quickshade. It looked very intriguing. My paint jobs of the past were satisfactory, but I saw miniatures that looked way better than mine, and eventually I learned that was because there's a thing called a wash, which I didn't know a heck of a lot about. And a lot of people just said, we can put base coats on our miniatures, we dip them in this quickshade, and they're awesome. They're great for the table. So I wanted to know more. I researched it, and I saw that the Armor Painter quickshade was really just a Minwax, and instead of dipping them and making a huge mess like some people do, you could also just brush it on. So I went to the hardware store, I picked up a tin, I painted up some Last Night on Earth zombies and heroes, a couple other miniatures, and just went to town testing it. It was pretty cool. I liked the thick armor shell. That was nice, especially on metal miniatures, but also was a bit too thick. And it was messy, it felt a little bit wasteful, and as I grew in the hobby, I just kind of left that behind. Wasn't really interested in dipping miniatures anymore. Till one day I was in my local hobby shop, and I saw these giant tubs of dipping formula. So they claim to be quick drying. Somewhere it says that. Somewhere on here, I think? I don't know. There we go. How to use. Can be applied by brush or figures, can be dipped directly into the pot. Dries fast and is recommended to remove the excess quickly. So I'm like, oh, okay. Because with the quickshade or the Minwax, it takes a very long time. And you have to clean it up with thinner of some sort. These ones, it's all water-based, so that seemed pretty cool. It is 200 milliliters, or 6.76 fluid ounces for people who measure that way. And this was less than $15 Canadian, which is super cheap. Very, very cheap. They claim to have realistic shading effects. Game color dipping wash is the perfect finish for models and miniatures. A water-based wash which quickly creates shadows and instantly brings volume and depth to your miniatures. Shake well before using. So I've been playing around with this. And first of all, do not shake well before using if you want to dip the miniatures. You're going to get a big thing of foam on the top. You don't want a big thing of foam on the top. I tested this one miniature here by dipping it into something I'd shaken up, and the foam basically prevented the wash from sticking. You know, it's just, it was too aerated. It didn't look very good. But the pigments settle a lot in these, so you really do have to mix it up somehow. So I tried it on my Vortex mixer, and you still get some sudding, but it's not as bad. It'll dissipate quicker. You have to turn the container over still, kind of slowly to mix it all together afterwards, but for the most part you get, well, not something that's not too bad. You could definitely dip in there. These are intriguing, especially just economy-wise. 200 milliliters is a lot of refills if you use Games Workshop. If you're using Nuln Oil, then you can replace it with the black. If you're using Seraphim Sepia, you can replace it with this stuff, and you just transfer over to your bottles if you prefer to work off a bottle, or put these in a dropper, which is the way I did it. It's very nice. They look good. I like working from dropper bottles for washes. I just put them right on my wet palette. Which is going to be our next test. I'm going to show you what they look like on the wet palette. Unfortunately, I do not have any Seraphim Sepia. Unfortunately, only because I can't do the test quite as properly without it. I do have this Vallejo Sepia Quickshade from the Game Color Wash line. And in this bottle, I have the Sepia from the Game Wash Dipping Formula. In a handy dropper bottle, which even if it does sud up a bit, it won't come out after you drop it on your palette, which is nice. So let's see if we can see any difference. So this is the original recipe. Thick. Stays where you put it. And this is the washing formula. A little less thick. It's a little bit nicer of a flow to it. They both do dry pretty fast though. Yeah, this one's a little bit more gel. I don't know if that's just because of the age of my wash or not. It could be. So I suspect that overall these are a slightly different and slightly better recipe. They definitely don't smell the same. I'll scratch that. They kind of smell the same. Close enough anyway. All right. All right, for the next test, I'll have some Nuln oil. I don't have any of the Vallejo game wash in this recipe, so I'm going to try the game ink. And then lastly, the game wash dipping formula. All right, Nuln oil first. Not too saturated. There. The ink, super dark as you'd expect. And then the game wash dipping formula. Can't really tell the difference to my naked eye. I don't know if it'll show up on camera as being slightly different, but the overall Nuln oil and the game wash dipping formula look fairly similar, and they definitely applied off the brush very similar. So I had two identical Thundara miniatures from HeroClix, and I decided to give it the sepia test on those. So I dipped the first one, and she came out super dark. I was not happy with that. Even wicking away all the wash was not very satisfactory. But I took my brush and I applied it by brush the second one, and she looked better. Still pretty dark. Definitely was something that you'd say to yourself, well, I'm going to have to re-highlight everything on these guys. But then I remembered that HeroClix are pretty much really invulnerable to paint stripping. You have to work really hard to get the paint off those. Acetone is the only thing I've ever found to remove the paint. So I took a cotton tip and I took some 91% isopropyl alcohol, and I waited till the wash dried and I rubbed off all the excess from the surfaces, and this is the result I ended up with. They look pretty good. You can see the Thundara that got dipped on the left, her base is a mess, and then the Thundara on the right was my brush. So definitely lighter on the right. Both look good, I would say, and I would use either one. Hassle-wise, though, I don't know. I mean, dipping is still kind of messy. Feels easier just to apply it by brush and then wick away what you don't want. So, you know, it's up to you what you want to do. Especially if you like the idea of shaking a miniature around. You can fling them for a bit. Try to get all that wash off. So, I want to run a couple of tests now. First test I want to do is I want to try dipping these skeletons, even though I don't think it's going to look that great. I have a little plan. If I dip the top and use a wet brush to move the paint down onto the base, and then I think maybe we can get a good effect. Let's see. So we'll hold them over. There. And move the paint down. Definitely pools. Draw a little more out. Actually, I have one more experiment I want to try too. It's all pretty good. There we go. Maybe a little more up there. And I'll grab a bit of the black. Throw it in a couple spots. Like I'll blend it into his shield. Make it a little darker. And a sword blade. Throw it on the back there too. Maybe a little on his little mouth. There we go. Pull a little more out. Add it there. All right, let's see how that dries. I'll do the other two as well. The next test will be this Hercules here. He's very fleshy, so he should look pretty good dipped. And this one, I'll clean up some of the excess, but I'll let it dry, and then I'll come back and I'll hit it with the isopropyl alcohol. Since the eyes are pre-painted, we'll make sure to wick some of that out so he maintains his nice, clear, totally straight, not weird at all, big old white eyes. Okay, I'll let him dry and the skeletons, and then we'll come back and see what they look like.